Good morning, children. Welcome back to the social session. Children, in the previous classes, we were trying to understand about trade in agricultural produce under part A and part B. We have seen many examples, right from Indira, Gauri, Chandrasekhar, Mallaya. Many kinds of examples we try to understand under this trading. So where the vegetable vendors go from one door to another door in order to sell their agricultural products, we have seen Indira, who visits weekly Santa, we have seen. And in the part B, under the Chandrasekhar's example, we have seen agricultural market yard, where he got very good price for his paddy cultivation. And the next one is Mallaya, where he sold his entire thing to the rice miller, okay, at a price, at a discounted price of 950 rupees per quintal. But whereas in today's example, we will see where Shanti was, the example of Shanti, where she is trying to sell her produce through the brokers. So who are these brokers and who is this Shanti? Let us see in today's class. Shanti is actually a farmer residing in Venkatapuram. After her husband passed away, she took up the cultivation of her 1.5 acres of land. So in order to cultivate this one, she has borrowed some 20,000 rupees from a self-help group, because she is also a member of self-help group, Dwakra Sangha, Women's Association in the villages. So this Swayam Sahayaka Kendra. So from there, she took a loan of 20,000 rupees. So her harvest for 1.5 acres was 14 quintals of paddy, and these she wanted to sell out of these 14 quintals, 7 quintals, and the rest she'll keep for the household purpose, that is for the consumption, for her own consumption. She wanted to keep some 8 quintals and remaining 7 quintals. The next day, a broker from the rice mill in Nalgonda came to the village and to buy the paddy in the village, and approached the farmers. He saw the Shanti's paddy and after much bargaining offered 1000 rupees per quintal. He weighed the bags and said that it was only 6.5 quintals. Shanti was shocked, because when she weighed, it was 7 quintals, and when he weighed, it was only 6.5 quintals. So she insisted on weighing it again and again. So in the presence of other self-help groups, this time it turned out to be 7 quintals. When he weighed, it was only 6.5, but in the presence of other self-help group members, when she requested to weigh it again, it was 7 quintals. The broker took the paddy and promised her to pay the money in 15 days. It was not spot money. In the issue of Mallaya, you have seen spot money. But in the issue of Chandrasekhar and in the issue of Shanti, it is not the spot money. It was only after 15 days. So 2 weeks later, he paid her rupees 6,825. Actually, how much should be given to her? 7,000 rupees. 7 quintals. And per quintal it is 1000, so 7000 should be paid, but he paid only 6820. How much actually has to be paid? Now see, 7 quintals she was selling, and each quintal was at 1000, so she should get 7000 rupees, but she got only 6825 rupees. That means there was a deduction. He had deducted 25 rupees per quintal as a brokerage, as a commission. So per quintal it is 25 rupees. So that 25 rupees he deducted from that. When we met Shanti and asked her some questions, so why you have not borrowed from any trader, and why don't you sell in the agricultural market yard, when such kind of question, because in agricultural market yard she would have got 1150 rupees, but here she sold only at 1000 rupees. So she told that to go to Nalgonda, I have to pay the tractor rent and loading and unloading charges. The higher price I get in a agricultural market yard will not cover even the transport cost. Moreover, my son and I will have to spare 1 or 2 days of this. We have very little to sell. Only farmers with a lot of paddy go to Nalgonda. But whereas we people, small farmers, doesn't go, we sell it in the village. That is what the Shanti replied. So why don't you ask for a higher price as most farmers sell at 1,000, 1,100 to 1,150, because the support price for paddy by the government itself is 1,080. Then why don't you ask for a more price? Then these brokers don't pay such high prices because we sell their produce from home to avoid trouble of running around to sell. And mostly brokers mediate between the farmers and the rice millers town based big millers and wholesale paddy merchants. They procure paddy in small quantities from farmers like Shanti, and they don't have permanent shops or godowns for doing their business. So they visit each farmer during the harvest season and negotiate with them to buy the paddy. So they collect a sufficient amount of paddy from the village and they sell it to the wholesaler or the rice miller, and inform the wholesaler or the rice miller owners who then send money and vehicles for transportation. This is what happens with the brokers. So they charge commission from both, from the farmers as well as from the miller. Some of them function as money lenders too. They even lend the money to the farmers and they even deduct the interest also while paying them. So we have seen in the case of Chendulal how the mill owner paid, lent money and deducted the interest and original principal amount also, and paid the remaining amount to the Chendulal. So while coming to the trading of paddy in Telangana, paddy is cultivated extensively in Telangana region. Mostly it is sold in the market and farmers keep only a small share for their own consumption. A considerable amount of paddy even produced by small farmers like Shanti is used for their own consumption even. And large farmers sell their produce in the agricultural market yard. Telangana farmers sell nearly 3/4 of their harvest within the village and 1/4 in the agricultural market yard. 3/4, that means majority is sold within the village itself, and only 1/3 is sold in the agricultural market yard. They own vehicles like tractors which reduce their transportation expenses. Those people will come to the market yard. In villages, many kinds of traders such as landlords, brokers, small rice millers, owners, they procure paddy from the village level. And on most occasions, small farmers like Mallaya and Chandrasekhar are bound to sell only to these traders as they borrow money from them. And even the people like Shanti also, who borrowed money from the self-help group, will sell to the brokers or to the small traders in order to avoid the transportation cost and to waste the time in the market yard. So coming to the indebtedness and selling paddy, so indebted may karza uthana padti, because if there is a bad harvest, they cannot repay this money, so they may have to incur into the losses. We saw small and medium farmers to borrow money from the landlords and from the traders in advance to purchase the fertilizers and even to the seeds and irrigational facilities. Since it is very difficult for them to get loans from the banks, they borrow from these people. And once a farmer borrows from them, he or she doesn't have any option to sell it in the market yard or at the price which is in the market, because it will be prefixed. The terms of the loan is you have to sell to the trader who has lent you the money, and at the price which is fixed by the trader. We have already seen the example of Mallaya in this regard. Paddy traders not only pay low prices but also cheat in weighing. In the case of Shanti, we have seen when he weighed, it was only 6.5 quintals, but when it was objected and it was re-weighed, then it came to 7 quintals. Moreover, they take commissions on the pretext of many things. Many of the farmers get delayed payments also. They don't get payment within 15 days, they get delayed payments. And since these traders and landlords lend money in desperate times, farmers have to sell that paddy only to them. They have no option to go for the market yard and participate in the auctioning. This is how the trade in the agricultural produce takes place, and we shall see in the next class about the remaining part of the context. So this is the end of the lesson, agricultural trade in agricultural produce. Hope to complete your fair notes, and thank you, children. Thank you very much.